Greetings, welcome to Let's Play the Strange and Somewhat Sinister Tale of the House at Desert Bridge. we're back in the lands of dream. You see my other Let's Play. Let's Play the Book of Living Magic. I just finished playing that one. This one is sort of a prequel to it, but different characters and a prequel in the sense that's based in the Lands of Dream, and he came out with this game before the Book of Living Magic. Jonas Kyratzes, again, some really interesting, excellent games, and I will put links in the description where you can download this game and read about it and such. Illustrated by Verena Huber. If it's the same Verena, I guess that now she has a married name, Kyratzes, so. And it has music by Helen Trevelyan, I suppose is how you say it, which is the same composer behind the Book of Living Magic. So, we're going to begin. Unlike the other game, this one is actually a download. So no, I'm not playing it on Jay's games. Hey, you. Yes, you, behind that screen. Yes, I'm talking to you. Don't look so confused. What? Yes, I'm a talking picture frame. Is there something strange about that? My name is Harold. Harold, the talking picture frame. Pleased to meet you. Sorry to have burst in on you like that. I'm sure that whatever you were previously doing was very enjoyable and commendable. I was playing Eye of the Beholder. However, this cannot wait. I must speak to you at once. We have a problem, and you are the only one who can help us. Old Man Bill is gone. We can't find him anymore. He might be in his study, but the room's locked and we can't get in. I would try getting in, obviously, but I'm stuck on the wall. And I worry. I worry quite dreadfully. Something sinister might have happened to poor old Bill, and we can't help him. That's why I summon help from beyond the screen, you see. It's the only thing I can do to help my creator. Through this window, you can interact freely with our world. Do please try not to break anything, though. I'll be glad to answer any questions you might have, of course, and so will all the others. We all miss the old man. The house is so empty without him, and we don't get many visitors out here. Yes, I did say out here. Out here in the desert. Or Desert Bridge, as they call the place. After the old bridge outside. No one knows what it's doing there, actually, but it's been around for ages, though there is no river to be found. Well, that's not surprising if you look at Tucson. There's bridges and riverbeds all over that are completely dry. Ah, well, I suppose you will figure it all out for yourself. It's better that way. Keep an open mind and all that. Here's a game menu to help you around. I shall leave you to it then. Good luck, stranger. And thank you for your help. What game menu? Unsurprisingly, the thing with the flowers sticking in it is a flower pot. It looks like half a table. You suspect it was designed that way. It's a coat hanger. No coats are currently attached to it. Who wears coats in the desert, anyway? Not me, that's for sure. It's a fan light, letting in light from the desert outside. Greetings, sir, madam, unknown underscore visitor. Should you wish to open this door, it's required that you provide the appropriate password. Thank you. Unfortunately, I must inform you that the password you have entered is incorrect. Please do try again. Ding ding. please do not touch these buttons. They are for decorative purposes only, and butler wear may be offended if you accidentally break one of them. Thanks, Jonas. Transdimensional window version 1.1. Righto. Tiny bits of wall have decided to relocate themselves to the floor. A bit of the paint has come off, revealing that the house was built from red bricks. It's kind of sad, really, to see it in this state. Unfortunately, these stairs are electrically powered, and the house is currently on backup power. What? No. Okay. well, the topics went away. Why, thank you. I am quite fine. Well, not really. I am quite worried. I wonder where my master has gone. Poor old Bill. He seemed worried in the last few days. Like something might happen. But he didn't say anything. I really am glad you're here, my dear player. You are the only hope we have of finding out what's happened to him. Old Man Bill, that's what his friends used to call him, or so he said. He's a wizard of technology, an inventor of magics, a deviser of things brilliant and unique. He built this house, and I would not be here without him. You see, that's why we have to find him. He is our master, our father. Bill's study. Yes, it's very important that you find some way of getting in there. He often spends a great deal of time in there. Maybe he's just forgotten to come out again. Or maybe he's hurt and needs our help. Anything is possible. As far as the house, Old Man Bill built it himself. It's quite large and full of surprises. It was much smaller when I was younger, but over the years he has expanded it to its present size. In many ways, it's like an oasis, a pool of life in the middle of the desert. We're all very happy here. Yes, you're communicating with us through a window on that screen of yours. It reaches directly into the lands of dream, though I believe you must use some manner of rodent to interact with us. Most peculiar, but then, as Old Man Bill used to say about the KV people of Kavianda, there is no thing stranger than culture, save for the KV. My old friend Jonas Kyratzes made this window so that I could contact you. He's a nice chap, that one. A little strange, granted, and hairy, but nice. Door password. Oh my, is butlerware not letting you out? It can be so priggish sometimes, insisting upon the smallest details of decorum. I fear there's not much we can do about it. I don't remember the password myself, but I know that Old Man Bill often forgot it too. And I think he wrote it down somewhere, probably somewhere in one of these rooms, though he wouldn't be able to find it when he needed it. Green lamp. It faintly smells of pears, or possibly of something else that is green and pear-shaped. Coat rack, hat rack, or modern orange. Paint is peeled off the wall. Looks like the house hasn't been maintained in a while. Bits of dried paint litter the floor. An orange carpet that smells of oranges. The blue carpet seems to be real, although it looks a little dilapidated. It is still very soft. Frankenstein or the Modern Prometheus by Mary Shelley. How to write anonymously. Author unknown. Onoropolis, University Guide to Metaphorical Beings, 7th edition. The complete works of William Blake with a preface by John Milton. Onoropolis University Dictionary of Non-Existent Terms, 2nd edition. Gothos is Falling by Gothos. Iscarel Puss Guide to Misdirection with a foreword by Krupp. A Short Guide to Katsuli Architecture by V. Gatta. If you've paid attention to... if you've played or paid attention to my Let's Play of the Book of Living Magic, You'll recognize some of these things like Onoropolis University and the Katsuli. Joram Duga's Incomplete Guide to Non-Fictional Disease Prevention, abridged. How to Build a Turtle Pond in the Desert by G. Raptimus. A yellow book. A green book. The Facial Expressions of Turtles, Myth or Reality, author unknown. Desert Architecture by Erg Chebi. A short dictionary of Bodawi terms. Famous quotes on the 11th century, annotated by the mutant priests of Gloop. Moab is My Washpot by Stephen Fry. Onoropolis University's Guide to the River Yan, 15th edition. The Liar by Stephen Fry, Tales of the Desert, 2nd edition. Sheridan's Guide to Oranges, Agamemnon edition. Oh, Sheridan from Babylon 5 loves orange blossoms. How to Grow Roses in the Desert Garden by Bob the Spider. Why I Hate Jellyfish by Verena Huber. Oracle Night by Paul Auster. Doomsday 09/10/2011. And Other False Prophecies. I bet you, this is the date I'm currently playing this. I bet you ought to put any date in there that, of which you're playing it at. The Complete Works of Akayana Daka, English Dayaya edition. The Voyage of the Beagle by Charles Darwin. Vindication of the Rights of Men by Mary Wollstonecraft. The Stranger from Paradise, a biography of William Blake by G.E. Bentley. The Case Against Trains by Neo Caddis. Time of the Gods by Lord Dunsany. Beowulf, The Monsters and the Critics by J.R.R. Tolkien. And The Use of Gas in the Streets of Darujistan by Rune London. Yeah, how much time we got left? A little bit. We can look at these books. Guide to the Seven Provinces of Katsuli by Bay B. Kattis. If you want to, like, skip to the next video, I'm going to look at all these books, and that's going to be the rest of this video, so feel free to move on if you want to. Otherwise, this is interesting. The Great Machine, System and Enslavement by J.K. Prudentius edition. A Visual Encyclopedia of Exploding Mushrooms by the Onoropolis University Exploding Mushrooms Department. The Age of Reason by Thomas Paine. The Complete Works of William Butler Yeats, illustrated by Jack R. Encyclopedia of Arda, 5th edition. The Collected Works of Fellison, edited by Stephen Erickson. The Gathering of the Life Stealers, author unknown. Letters to the Eastern Front, Reflections on the Third War of Magic by Mika Handori. Night Thoughts by Edward Young. New Symmetries, Advanced Quantum Chromodynamics and QCD Matter by Fred Bobble. The Gospel of Judas, annotated edition. The Early Years of the Great Revolution, 152-160 by R. Locke. Complete Works of William Shakespeare, Katsuli Oracle Edition. The Magnificent M, Accomplished Illusionist or Depraved Monster. Depraved Monster, actually, by S. Else. Someone else? The Book of Bad Puns by Paronomasia. Physics and Magic, Aspects of Force by Herb Al Teetrinker, Joseph Brom et al. The History of Katsuli, Book 11. 3009-3109 by Mick Rogataki. To Zahadun, a biography of John J. Sheridan by Eduardo Del Vientos. To Fight Legends. King John by William Blake. Maps of Southern Belzoond, University of Dunsany. The Prophet by Khalil Gibran. A Guide to Protective Spells by Hermione Granger. The Feeding Hamsters of Hamsters of Doom, by C. Rice attest. This same book is in Dr. McShelfish's, his library and laboratory. Encyclopedia Trifusica, edited by Trifusis. Umbria City Map, Shadow Edition. Book of Good Puns by Paranomasia. Language and Nature in the Arch of Patricia MacKillop by the Seer of the Green Sea, and The Complete Works of Emperor Calenved, edited by Shadow Throne. Alright, thanks for watching, and see you in the next episode. Take care.